All right, what's up, everyone? Okay, so this is a situation that I think mostly everyone that has worked in the restaurant kitchen has gone through something similar. So I wanted to kind of show you. This is a clip from Hell's Kitchen. Let's get into it.
We can fire the next course.
How long to fire?
Eight.
8 minutes is good.
Are you sure?
No. You,
Come on.
Let's go 10.
10?
10.
Let's go. I mean, let's go 8 then. 8 is good.
8 minutes.
So right there, you already kind of have a feeling that this person doesn't seem too confident. Maybe it's just the way they edited the whole, you know, this whole clip, but definitely doesn't seem a very confident answer. So we'll see. It's almost like he just wants to get it over with. So let's see.
2 minutes.
Fire her. 12 feet. Let's go. 8 hurt.
Come on, Red Team. We got this tonight. This is a huge dinner. I'm feeling good. So let's kill this. You know, let's work together and let's stay focused. Start that broccoli. Make sure it's nice.
Already going.
Beautiful. Bro, how you looking over there, Maro?
I'm good. Good.
Come on, guys.
Give it a chance to get a little more color.
I've actually worked with this chef a couple years ago. Actually, now it's probably like 10 years. No. Yeah. A little bit less than 10 years ago. She actually, last time I know, she came back. Like, I guess she didn't win this season, but she ended up coming back for, I guess, like a reunion, and she ended up winning. Very good chef. I work with her. She was good. And I also work with other chefs that were in Hell's Kitchen and other food shows, and they weren't that good. But she was good. I'll give her that. She was very good.
A little bit more color than that? Tiny bit more. I have the veal saltimbocca, which is veal wrapped in prosciutto, and I'm going to own it.
And
mark
sage.
My words. Drop in butter.
Don't put the butter in too early. Half that butter.
Half that amount hurt.
We can always add butter.
That gives me a little idea. I might have to do veal saltimbocca. It's been a long time.
You can't take it away.
Yes, chef.
Come on. Beautiful.
Here.
Wipe.
Sauce.
Wipe down.
Drop the sauce. Start wiping.
Move
the plates,
over.
Bro.
Move over. Wipe down plates, please. I'll follow with sauce.
Wipe the plates, please. Somebody wipe the plates.
I got plates.
I got plates.
Come on, let's go.
Very nice, Heather.
Thanks, chef.
Service, please. Go, please.
Do you think we can get you to crack
without
a smile?
To see
there you
plates.
Go.
Now. What?
It looks amazing.
Oh, my God.
Wow.
Come on, guys, please.
Put it up. Come on, put it up. That's perfect.
How's that?
And you see the plate up is very simple, clean, and there's nothing wrong with it. It's a pretty big portion, actually, for fine dining. But it's a very clean dish, the sauce. I actually not sure what the yellow stuff is. It might be polenta. If it is polenta, it just looks very simple. Polenta and broccoli, Rob? No. Broccolini, I think. Pretty sure it's broccolini.
Hey, are you happy with that?
Yes, chef.
Go.
It's so tough. Oh, my gosh. Mine is completely raw.
See, this is what you would call raw.
Yours is raw. Oh, yours is raw.
We got it out. Let's get ready for dessert.
Oh, no. Red team, come here.
Yes, chef.
Oh, fucking hell.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, I haven't seen this show, but I just feel bad. Like, I feel bad. I mean, he was playing basically the executive chef at this point, and he did not cook it, but as the executive chef, it doesn't matter. Anything that goes wrong in the kitchen is your fault. That's just kind of what it is, no matter what. It could be stuff that you're not even aware of, but it's your fault. It's your kitchen. Whatever happens is your fault. I mean, yeah, the person that cooked it is going to get a little bit, but it's your fault.
Oh, shit.
Raw. Wow.
Shit. Who cooked it?
I was cooking veal along with Trev.
Jose, did
yes,
you check?
Chef. Most of them. I didn't open them up,
though.
And that's what happens. You got to check your food. I mean, sometimes, look, you got to kind of check and confirm. You got to trust and confirm. But at this type of contest where everybody, you don't really know the people that well, or you haven't worked with them for years or months, yeah, you want to check. That's why it's like if you leave Murphy's Law, if you leave opportunity for something to go wrong, especially in this situation, like normally in your kitchen, you would not check every single plate. Like if you're getting a party and they order the same thing, if you check a couple, usually they all cook the same time and cook together. It should be all kind of the same temperature. So you do a couple of checks, but in this type of setting, in the competition, and things are not being necessarily, well, actually, where the whole table eat the whole thing. So this is, yeah, that's why you check everything in this, in a situation like this.
Oh, no.
Oh, my God.
No. No. Fuck. Guys, come here at the back.
As a chef, I'm just going to say that's raw. And I don't know if he checked because, honestly, a little touch, you would have been able to tell that, yeah, this is raw or this is not cooked or well. You could just touch it like most chefs. Like, I just touch it and I can tell you, okay, this is, needs a little bit more fire. Is overdone, whatever, but the temperature, you can just do it by touch. So that's so raw that there's no way that was, I don't know, that's like raw. Like, just it looks like it was just seared in the outside. The prosciutto was just seared in and that was it. Or it was not finished off.
Look at this.
Jose dropped the ball. Not one of them was cut into. It looks like something out of a horror movie that you peeled off a radioactive mine.
I give you that. None of them was cut into, but he didn't even have to cut into. When it, like, you don't need to cut into. You cut into steaks when you freaking serving a steak? No, you touch it. This is the same concept. You shouldn't be cutting stuff anyway. You should just be able to know by, you know, you should just know by touching this stuff.
Monster's back. Oh, it looks like a giant scab.
Just touch that.
Exactly.
Mourinho! All this...
Thank you, Gordon. Like, thank you, chef. You definitely would, all you gotta do is touch it, you know. Like, you could just tell it's...
More coming back.
Probably
oh,
all
fuck, no. No, 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 no!
I need six.
Oh, shit. Oh, my God.
I think people are getting hit in the head with broken plates.
This is crazy. I wish I could have cooked the veal myself. I feel like my team let me down, for sure.
You!
First of all, you can't cook everything. You can't. That's why you gotta have people that can cook it, and you just gotta be able to... Shit's gonna happen. Shit's not gonna come 100% perfect every single time. Especially at this type of setting. This is like a fast pace. You can say fine dining, but it's really not fine dining. This is a much more like... It's what people say fine dining without really necessarily being 100% fine dining. This is a much higher pace. Fine dining is you slow everything down. Quality is mostly everything. Service is everything. And this is a competition too. But because it's a competition, you definitely even check the stuff even more. Don't leave stuff up to chance when it comes to something like this.
Get on with the
souffle!
Yes, chef! You! Get on with the souffle!
Chef.
Oh my God.
It was up to you to do what was needed, Jose. Not me, not Mato, not Brett. And you didn't check one thing. You just fucking screwed us, bro.
I cannot believe it.
Don't get me wrong. Look, yeah, the guy messed up, but competition, it's like... It's a team. I get it. He was in charge, but other people usually kind of... person that was cooking it, first of all, at the end of the day... fucked up. Yes, he fucked up because he didn't check, but the main person, even though the chef gets the blame, the guy that doesn't know how to cook a freaking piece of veal, that's really the problem.
Oh boy, I cannot believe it.
If Chef Ramsay's cooking for us, that means we fucked up real bad.
Send the four, please, Christina.
Yes, chef.
Yes, when the chef is cooking, and I always say, if you got to get, if I come behind the line, we in trouble, like, we messed up. Like, if I gotta bail people out, yeah, we in a problem. We in the weeds, something is wrong, because that's usually the only time, unless if it's called for me to be in the line. Don't get me wrong, I did a lot of line cooking at my restaurant and other restaurants too, but the majority of the time, you're... like a real executive chef position, you're not necessarily cooking as a line cook most of the time, especially in bigger operations. You just can't. You have to have your eyes in too many things. In small operations, yeah, you can be in the line and you can kind of watch a little bit of everything, but big operations, it's almost impossible for you to be a really productive executive chef and an efficient executive chef if you're stuck behind a line for long periods of time. That's just, it's just the truth.
We're lucky chef didn't stab us or something.
So I really stopped watching a lot of these chef shows like years ago. Like I've worked with a lot of these people, even from the beginning of Hell's Kitchen and some of the other Gordon Ramsay show. I work with many of these people that have been in these shows. I actually went to school with some of the people. One of the people that won Top Chef was somewhat of a friend in college. So I know a lot of these people, and I get it. This is a different type of setting than a regular restaurant. But still, you know, it is what it is. It's a lot of that stuff that you do in your restaurant should carry over these competitions. And I got to be actually a little bit, I guess, more comfortable with, you know, letting stuff like that happen because it's a competition. That's all I got to say. Leave your comments below. Be safe later.